Hello traders, this is Ravindra Rao and you are listening to the Commodity Weekly Podcast for April 6, 2021. We have entered a new financial year with the US dollar index retreating from its highest level since November 2020. It touched November 2020 highs as a strong US non-farm payrolls number helped the US currency. The DXY index moved 0.3% higher to 93.01. However, the new financial year and the new week started with some corrective dip in the currency as it didn't sustain above 93. A strong resistance remains at 94. So until that holds, there is a great chance that the US dollar might correct more. On the bonds front, the US treasuries remain dislocated to most other major government bonds. The 10-year US treasury yield is still above the breakout point of 1.50%. Last week it rose 2 bips to close at 1.68%. The up move is expected to continue until 1.50% holds. However, the upside, we expect the upside might be limited now. COMEX Gold witnessed a strong rebound from the support near $1,676, which has now become a double bottom support. However, on weekly basis, it ended with a 0.4% a decline, making its second weekly fall. Gold has been trading in a broad range for the last few days, largely taking cues from the US dollar. Gold is garnering support from US stimulus measures, loose monetary policy stance of major central banks, resurgence in virus cases, and mixed economic data from major economies. But higher bond yields, robust US currency, and continuing ETF outflows have been limiting the gains. Although gold seems to be trading higher this week, a sharp rise is possible only if we see a sharp correction in US dollar or bond yields. On the technical front, COMEX Gold is trading near the resistance of $1,750. For the bulls to get an edge, price should close above the resistance band. In that scenario, the bulls might target $1,800 to $1,820. Strong double bottom support remains near $1,670. On the MCX, a bullish engulfing candlestick pattern at the lower level is providing the required support for the bulls. Immediate upside is pegged at 45,700. Close above 45,700 would give the bulls the required edge to push it further higher towards 46,600. Support of the bullish engulf pattern is near 44,100, below which the bullishness might fade. The white metal silver has recently underperformed gold as seen from the gold silver ratio that has moved up again near 70. A higher ratio indicates that silver is underperforming gold. A corrective move in industrial metals have pulled silver prices lower towards 24 on the COMEX. However, a rebound in gold prices has provided a floor to silver, which has rebounded towards $1.25. We now expect gold to lead and silver might play the catch-up game and might trade in a broader range. Technically, silver is still in a short-term bear grip. The bulls might get an edge only if it sustains above $26.50. On the MCX, 66,500 would be an immediate resistance and strong resistance is pegged at 68,000. Until then, a broad range would continue in silver. Coming to energies, a sharp decline in crude oil, sharp volatility was witnessed in the last week. The commodity ended with a minor 0.8% gain. The biggest event for the week was OPEC and ALEI's production policy meeting. In the meeting, it was decided to add back 350,000 barrels per day in May, 350,000 in June, and 4 lakh in July. Meanwhile, Saudi Arabia in the same period might restore an additional 1 million barrels per day in cuts that it made on its own. More supply online in coming months is providing a negative case for prices as WTI crude fell below $1.58 at the start of this week. Also weighing on prices is a rise in virus cases, which has forced countries to impose stricter restrictions, including travel restrictions. Rise in crude oil rig count to April 2000 highs is also haunting oil market. Supply concerns relating to the Suez Canal also eased with the release of a stuck container ship. So crude oil is likely to witness volatile trade. However, the general bias may be on the downside owing to demand concerns amid rising virus cases and prospect of higher supply in the coming months. On the technical front, strong support is pegged at $57.20 in case of WTI crude. Closing break might pull the price lower towards $54. On the MCX, multiple bearish candlestick patterns like dark cloud cover and bearish engulfing has been formed at the top levels, which has pulled the prices lower. Support is pegged near 4,250. Break might take it till 4,080 to 4,000 levels. Resistance remains at 4,540 and then 4,640. Lastly, in case of base metals, most of the metals on the LME noted mixed movement last week, with most metals ending on a lower note. LME aluminium was the worst performer with a 3.15% decline, followed by 2% drop in zinc and 1.9% slide in copper prices. In other metals, nickel prices too ended 1.1% lower. However, LME lead ended with a modest 0.6% gains. The metals pack bearing copper traded in a narrow range at the start of this week amid a lack of cues apart from copper on the LME. LME was closed yesterday on account of Easter Monday. Copper prices on MCX were up about 3% yesterday, supported by demand optimism from top consumers China and US, along with retreat in US dollar index from last week's November 2020 high. On the demand front, last week's upbeat factory activity data, especially from China and US, along with the US infrastructure plan, is fanning demand outlook for the base metals at large. Also lending support to metals pack at large is accelerating pace of vaccinations despite few hiccups. The gains may, however, be capped amid renewed worries related to virus, along with lingering worries over uneven pace of economic recovery, and is evident from mixed economic data from the major economies. Overall, the metals pack is witnessing range-bound moves for past few sessions amid mixed cues on macro as well as fundamental front, and we expect this consolidation to persist this week too. Well, to sum up, for the week, moves in US dollar index may be impacted by comments of various Fed officials, including comments by Fed Chair Jerome Powell. Also, focus may be on the FOMC minutes along with economic data from the US. Data wise, the week seems to be quiet apart from employment claims and PMI data. Well, that's all from this edition. Good luck and trade safe.